deployed other technology to support the office of the deputy president. Mr. Chairman, I ask the indulgence of the committee. My colleagues here, the heads of the agencies, will not allow me to discuss operational issues and the difficult issue. All I can say here is that we have sufficient assets, and actually, because of the budget that you have given us consistently, our acquisitions have kept going up year in, year out. And we have acquired sufficient assets to protect our leaders. There is none of them who is in any particular danger. And of course, the deputy president of the country is not in any danger at all. We have sufficient assets, we have sufficient personnel, we are fine, and we are protecting him without a problem. I would not like to go to operational issues and address those kinds of. The independence of the office of the inspector general, that is why sometimes we ask the question, do we actually respect this independence? When the inspector general takes discretion, because of information he has, makes presentations and raises issues and talks with us and so on and so forth, and then every so often we come back to excoriate him, to Mr. Chairman, as our leader in security, you know this, and all of you members of parliament who belong to this committee, you know the number of decisions that the IG makes on a 24-hour cycle is incredible. We can't second guess them. They make these decisions independently, but of course they consult with the other organs of the security environment. And we all agree with them on this particular decision he made to make the rearrangement. We are all aligned. We are all agreed. I wish those who are actually raising concerns about this, especially because they have access to facts and they can get this information, they look for the information and facts about it. Allow me, Mr. Chairman, sir, to not comment anything about that issue of G4S. I don't want to trivialize the matters of this country and the security of our country in that kind of manner. I don't want to be that petty. I mean, we are a serious country. We are respected around the world. We are a serious government elected by the people of Kenya, given serious responsibilities. I would not like to comment and to be so flippant as to comment on things like those about Chief Wise and so on. On the issue of lastly, applying the law selectively, you gave me discretion to skip the answer, but suffice it to say, we are not applying the law selectively. Sometimes it boils down to people also taking moral responsibilities as national leaders, because it gets to that point. The lives of the people we lead is also a matter of your moral responsibility as a leader. Thank you, sir.